my love, there's only you in my life, the only thing that's right.
My first love, you're every breath that I take, you're every step I make.
For you, I'm sure. chosen forever. No one will ever love you better. And when I'm gone, I'll still be true to you. The seed of love lives inside of you. I'll be your angel up there in heaven, and all my love will shine down on you.
When jealousy burns, Guess I'm on my way. Needed a friend, and the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Guess I'm on my way. Mighty glad you stayed. Stuck on you, been a fool too long, I guess it's time for me to come on home. Guess I'm on my way. So hard to see that a woman like you could wait around for a man like me. Guess I'm on my way.
to stay. I'm on my way. Needed a friend, and the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Yes, I'm on my way. I'm mighty glad you stayed.
Used to think that love was just a fairy tale, until that first hello, until that first smile. But if I had to do it all again, I wouldn't change a thing, 'cause this love is everlasting. Suddenly suddenly you're in love. Ooh, yeah. Girl, you're everything a man could want and more. 1,000 words are not enough to say what I feel inside. Holding hands as we walk along the shore. Never felt like this before. Now you're all I'm living for. Suddenly and suddenly you're in love. Each day I pray this love affair would last forever. Suddenly suddenly you're in love. Ooh, there's beauty up above, things we never take notice of. you're in love.
I'm not afraid to die. nobody but me. Yeah.
The nights are lonely, the days are so sad, and I just keep thinking about the love that we had. And I'm missing you, and nobody knows it but me.
Just to be close to you, girl, just for a moment, well, just for an hour, just to be close to you, girl. You know, I've been through so many changes in my life, girl. Oh, I've been up real high where I thought I didn't need anybody. Oh, and then again, I've been down real low where there was no one in my life that needed me. Oh, and I found that material things I thought had so much value. Oh, girl, didn't really have any value at all. That I was a lonely man, a man with no direction, with no purpose, with no one to love, and no one to love me for me. Oh, girl, then you came into my life. You made my jagged edges smooth. You made my direction so clear and new. Oh, woman, you became my purpose, my reason for living, girl. You see, you're my heart, you're my soul, you're my stone inspiration, baby. Oh, that's why I'm standing here singing and opening my arms to you. I wanna say, child, why don't you? Oh, we'll live in love forever, yeah. Ooh, we'll be alone, you and me, yeah. Girl, we'll live our lives together, yeah, together.
Together, yeah.
Oh. Just for an hour, just to be close to you, girl. Hey, hey, ooh, 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 ooh. I've been out there searching so very long, baby, searching to find just like you. And for some folks, it takes a lifetime, sugar, to find in this world a dream come true. Why don't you? Oh, we'll live in love forever.
Together,
just to be close to make love, to be loved by your baby, to have your warm body close to mine, to whisper words that make you feel like a woman. Girl, I know our love will stand the test of time. Just to be close to you, girl. For the moment, baby.
For the moment, baby. For the moment, baby. For the sugar, sugar, yeah, yeah.
Hey, girl, I wanna say,
with so much love, and I need someone I can call my own to fall in love. That's what everyone's dreaming of. I hold this feeling oh so strong. Life is too short alone, without someone to call my own. I will care for you, you will care for me. Our love will live forever.
My love, there's only you in my life, the only thing that's right.
My first love, you're every breath that I take, you're every step I make.
That beat as one, our lives have just begun.
Forever,
I'll hold you close in my arms. I can't resist your charm. For you, I'm sure.
the way you squeeze and moan and call out my name. Ooh, you can call me baby. I remember you love to take your time to get in the mood. Ooh, yes you do, yeah. But once you're in the mood, straight to the groove. Oh, yes you do, girl. It's been so long since we've had a night together. I miss you. Will I get through loving you, girl? Fire and desire will burn.
Guess I'm on my way. Need any friend? And the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Guess I'm on my way. Mighty glad you stayed. Stuck on you, been a fool too long. I guess it's time for me to come on home. Guess I'm on my way. So hard to see that a woman like you could wait around for a man like me. Guess I'm on my way. Mighty glad you stayed. In my soul that I just can't lose. Guess I'm on my way. Need a friend, and the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Guess I'm on my way. I'm mighty glad you stayed.
You are so lovely. With you standing there, I'm so aware of how much I care for you. You are more than now. You are for always. I can see in you my dreams come true. Don't you ever go away. You make me feel like there's nothing I can do. And when I hold you, I only want to say I love you. Ballerina girl, the joy you bring me every day and night.
This is the greatest bride in town. Please, may you know your name?
Yeah,
Tessie. Tessie who?
Okay, let me put it in full. Teresa Itwaje Agboyena.
Soon to be.
Mrs. Francis Omori.
Okay, Chris. Where do the sincere? Is the sincere? The first time he met you and said, "I love you." How do you feel?
I felt good.
You feel good?
Yeah.
So you were on some motion and the, I don't know. What of that very day he says, "Chris, will you marry me?"
It was better.
It was better. How do you feel?
Yeah, I feel great.
Being inside this wedding gown?
I feel great.
Okay. What do you wish your
two best men?
I wish her well. Soon as she's going to be, as I pull off this gown, I wish she'd take it over.
Yeah. Okay, I know you have some, even before he came, there's some sisters that are coming. Okay. And how do you turn them down? Why?
It's better,
personal.
But then, it's
better. Then
yeah,
it's better. Okay, please, can you tell us the little thing you find in him that makes you accept his proposal?
He's caring, he's lovely.
He's caring?
Yeah.
And lovely?
That is why I call him my daddy.
Oh, wonderful. And that's what every woman wants. Man that is caring. Okay. That is nice, that is wonderful. Okay, what do you wish your husband?
I wish him the very best. From this moment onwards, his life should be better than we met. Yeah, I wish him the very best. All we run.
That's wonderful. That's beautiful. I know it's quite sad. You're leaving your younger ones and your mom. What do you have to tell them?
They stay cool.
They stay cool.
We keep contact.
Yes.
Yeah, we always keep contact.
Like, lovely, because I was somewhere in Anambra last week.
Okay.
The bride was crying. I said, why?
Emotional,
but how are you going to cry today? Are you going to cry?
I can't see.
Okay.
I can't see.
He's quite wonderful. Thank you very much. And I pray that we as all of us production have nothing to offer now. But what we offer is word of God that says that who that find a wife find a good thing and he obtains favor from the Lord. That favor of God is going to be your people's portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And like what happened in Acts of Apostles chapter 3 verse 6, Simon Peter, they were walking to the temple, they saw a layman there, they have nothing to offer.
Amen.
But they now realize that there's something that Christ left in them, which they really apply that very day, and it works for them. That's the same thing we're applying to you people, that if there is any advantage or if there's any disadvantage, as soon as you people joined together, it became advantage to you people. In Jesus' name. Thank you very much.
You.
And God bless you.
Thank you.
Hello, Chief Bridesmaid.
Hello.
Once again, you're welcome.
Yeah, Teresa, Etwaje, Agboyeme.
Please, just do one thing. Just kiss your husband. I know he's going to say it. You know?
Oh, damn. I love you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you.
Wonderful. I'm coming back.
Good morning.
Sir. Please, your name?
My name is Joyce Aboyeme.
Joyce who?
Aboyeme.
Joyce Aboyeme. Who are you to the bride?
It's my elder sister.
It's the elder sister, and you're the one. And today you're very happy?
Yeah, I'm very
happy. Why? Why are you so happy?
very happy because this is her wish before now.
Yes.
Her preparation before now, what she had dreamed for a long time.
And just coming through.
And just coming through.
That's wonderful.
I'm very happy.
And what are your prayers to her?
Well, my prayers to her is a successful marriage life.
Yes.
A happy home. God-fearing, brought up children. In all we run, blessing. God's blessing.
Wonderful. As she's leaving you people.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
Wow. I really feel somehow I'll feel lonely because she has been keeping me company at home. I'll really miss her.
Okay. We think of everything.
Yeah.
But for instance, if today is your day, what will come start from your heart?
I would be very, very happy.
Heaven would have been your image. That's nice, my sister. Well, we wish you that a day will come.
Yeah.
Your own day is going to be better than what we're seeing today. And you won't just meet just a man, but a man that will know what you want. A man that will know that you are so important. That is our wishes to you. God bless you.
Thank you very much.
Your name is too. Wonderful.
Sometimes I wonder if you'd ever come my way. Now that I finally found you, this is where my heart will stay. Oh.
off record and listen.
I want us to ease this tension. The couple, you can sit down. You are honorable people. God bless you in Jesus' name. Okay. Today, we want to start the wedding program proper. But I wanted to shout a very loud hallelujah to Jesus for this victory. If you know that you know that you want to see the next marriage in your family, you will not die before them. Shout a louder hallelujah. Amen. Okay, sit majestically on your seat. We want to declare the program open by singing the opening hymn, Psalm 209, in page 3 of your program.
the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. We give you glory. We give you praise. We give you honor for a day like this, that your grace is sufficient upon us, giving us privilege to come and join your son Francis with your daughter together, Teresa. And thank you for giving the grace for all these witnesses to be here, their parents to witness their children's wedding. What a great day. What a wonderful blessing. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Father, we are grateful for making this very day a reality. Thank you for removing every obstacles on the way. Blessed be your name. Lord, we now say, send forth your angels to be with us. Holy Spirit, be present. Help us to wear these couples for your glory, for your honor, for your praise, that our joy will overflow. In the name of Jesus, that what we are doing today will be confirmed in heavens above. That every day of their life, every year, they will all remember this honorable day. But their joy will overflow.
Amen.
And the name of God will be glorified.
Amen.
Thank you, my Father,
Amen,
that you are present. Jesus and Holy Ghost is present in the wedding of today.
Amen.
And to bless the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, my Father.
Amen.
I will cover this congregation with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
And perfect all we are going to do.
Amen.
In Jesus' holy name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Let the living shout it louder, amen. If you are happy, shout it louder, amen. Okay, we turn the service once again over to the choir for their special ministration.
Oh,
general in the Lord's vineyard, a spiritual father indeed, the one who can love, correct, and amend, and even force situations to God. Put your hands together. Ask me a question. Is honeymoon real? Is it real? To those who have gone through it, they know honeymoon is real. And I believe Francis and Teresa are about to experience their honeymoon. Shout hallelujah. Is also wedding cake real? I don't know whether Teresa has prepared one today. And that is where I am interested. Because I want to chop the wedding cake today. I hope it is ready. If it's not, call the person who, if he didn't bring in time, he will pay 50,000. Amen. So because we all will participate from that, so we enjoy the wedding cake while we enjoy the wedding honeymoon. Amen.
Amen.
So having said that, let's quickly go to the declaration while we are here today. Dearly beloved, we are gathered in the sight of God and before the congregation to join together this man, Francis Amori, and this woman, Teresa Agbonyeme, in a holy matrimony, which indeed is honorable estate and is instituted by God, which Christ adorned and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee. Scripture teaches is indeed an honorable estate and is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, and with the fear of God. For the two shall become one flesh. Thus, marriage is ordained by God for mutual and society, help and comfort that one has to have to the other. Secondly, it was ordained for the presence of procreation of children and to be brought up in the fear and nature in the Lord and to the praise of his holy name. Thirdly, it was ordained for remedy against sin, to avoid fornication, so that such persons as have no gift of contingency might marry and keep themselves undefiled of the body of Christ. It is the holy estate that these two present have come to be joined. Therefore, if any man can show any just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let him now speak or forever hold his peace. Shout loud hallelujah. I am happy. There's no reason why this our handsome young man
should not be married to our beautiful sister Teresa. So we give God the glory. Shout louder, hallelujah. I say, greet Jesus with louder, hallelujah. Amen. Yes, I require and charge you both as we answer on the dreadful day of judgment, when the secret of all hearts will be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediment why you may not be lawfully joined together in holy matrimony, do now confess it. Is there any reason? Please give him a mic. I'm not hearing him. I want to hear. Is there any reason?
No, sir.
Oh, Teresa. Is there any reason?
No, sir.
I didn't hear you.
No, sir.
I'm not hearing you.
No, sir.
Oh, give Jesus a clap offering. Seated. The Lord be with you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you. Hallelujah!
Somebody just stand up for confession. He's watching now. Ah, somebody is fast. Just say, no, my son, no, sir. Amen. So go over to the next item on the program, this choir. I will give us the second hymn so that will not be like reading. We are taking the second hymn in the fifth page. You see it in the fourth and fifth page of your program. Together, I sat me welcome. Pastor, you borrow those and come church. If you break, you go pay. Okay, and I will pray too. I pray for not the hand. This man is highly anointed. So if you want to clap, clap well. Put your hands together. Morning from Bible book of Genesis chapter number 2 from verse 18 through 25, and I read, and the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him an helpmeet for him. And out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air, and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. 20. And Adam gave name to all cattle, and the fowls of the air, and every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was no found and help meet for him. And the Lord God said, and the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh inside thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from the man made he a woman, and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, this is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. 25, the last. And they shall both naked, the man and the wife, and they were not ashamed. They were both naked, the man and his wife, and they were not ashamed. I pray God to give us understanding. Amen. Of his word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Okay, please, can I get two able young men? Please, sir, come. Let's all, do we have the ushers? I can't see, this is a very organized program. We don't have ushers. I can see nobody standing, everybody sitting there comfortably. So, you know, the man and the wife, they look like whites. So maybe they organize the package program. Help us take this one.
Yes,
that way.
Yes, we want to know who gave Teresa Agmoyeme in marriage to Francis Omori. Yes, can we see the father of the bride? Uh-huh. This young man you want to hand over to, has he paid the bride price? Are you sure? Because we will not wear someone who never paid bride price, so they are paid. And you are happy. You are satisfied. He has satisfied the family. Give Jesus a clap offering. Amen. Amen. Thank you very much. We appreciate you. And let me ask one question. You still get a beautiful girl who will still marry. And that one today. Hallelujah. Amen. You are blessed. Move forward a little, my daughter. Thank you. Yes. Move forward, my graciously. Hand over to you, Hola. Amen. God bless you. Stay with me now. Francis Omori, will you have Teresa Agboyeme to be your lawful wedded wife, to live together after God's holy ordinance in the estate of matrimony. Will you love her, care for her, honor, keep her, standing with her in faith to obtain victory through all circumstances that may arise, forsaking all of that and keeping holy to her as long as you both shall live? You do.
Yes, I will.
Shout hallelujah. And put your hand together. I want to hear you clapping. That is wonderful. Praise the Lord. My beloved sister Teresa, Agmayohen, to be your lawful wedded husband, to live together after God's holy ordinance in the estate of matrimony. Will you love him, care for him, honor and keep him, standing with him in faith to obtain victory through all circumstances that may arise, forsaking all others and keeping holy to him as long as both shall live?
Yes, I will.
I didn't hear you.
Yes, I will.
I said, I didn't hear. Right. Francis Omori, will you take Teresa Moyeme to be lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold from the day forward? Amori,
take you,
Teresa,
Agboyeme,
to be my lawful wedded wife,
to have, to hold,
from this day forward,
for better,
for the best,
in riches,
in wealth,
in health.
In peace,
to love,
to cherish,
he
then
to us part,
according to God's holy law.
Therefore,
in the presence of these people,
as witness,
I give you my truth. Amen. Okay, Teresa, listen with me. I, Teresa,
take you,
Francis Omori,
to be my lawful wedded husband,
to hold,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse, whether you believe it or not. Marriage, there will be trials, there will be temptations. No marriage without temptation. Are you hearing me? Whether you use for best, whatever you use, God will deliver you from all temptations. In Jesus' name. In riches.
In
wealth. In
health.
In peace.
To love.
To cherish.
He then do us part.
According to God's holy law. And they unto. In the presence of these people.
As a witness.
Give you my truth. Shout hallelujah. Yes. Thank you very much. Faith. He can be lost for one reason and the other. You can pack that one to change. Probably We have believed in silver, you can buy gold, and so on. But this, we place it upon the word of God. So the word of God is a witness. It will never fade. The word of God is permanent. So that's why we place it here. And by the word of God, we want to bless it. Amen.
Amen.
Bless, O Lord, this ring, which we hallowed in thy name. Grant that they who shall wear them may keep through faith, that they both may abide in thy peace, according to the will, and ever live in mutual love, unto their lives, and through Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We bless the ring for the honor and glory of your name. Your ring will cover you with the blood of Jesus. Your ring will cover you with the blood of Jesus. And this will destroy any other ring that is not from God, because it is covered with the blood of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Shout loud hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My friend, and you will sing with me. Say this day, with my body, I did worship with my worldly goods. I did endow in the name of the Father. You will start from here. Yes. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of thy Son. In the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. Yes, my sister. Then you say today.
With this ring.
I did wed. With my body. I did worship. With my worldly goods,
I did endow.
In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Shalom. Hallelujah.
Come this way.
Listen carefully. Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much Teresa and Francis are consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and this congregation, have sealed their solemn vows by giving and receiving of ring from each other. And now, by the authority vested on me, therefore pronounce you husband and wife. In the presence of God and this congregation, the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Shout out the hallelujah. Everybody stand by your feet.
that want to stand will be leveled down. Pray, everybody.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, the King of all glory, we thank you for this opportunity you have granted us to witness this union. We thank you, Lord, because you have made us alive to witness this thing. We say may your name be glorified in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask this morning, every worthiness, because of this ceremony, anything we may have done that will stand against us on the last day, we ask for mercy.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we ask, oh God, that you will accept this union.
Amen.
Above all, Lord, let it be a blessed union.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Blessed be your name, because we know that you have done today is perfect and shall be perfected forever.
Amen.
For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Is your father here? You, your father here. Let him come. You are the father. You are welcome, Baba. Bless this man.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, thank you for that person for making this ceremony possible today. Thank you, Father. If I do well today, good control over it, cover them. As we join together, for them to live forever. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. My daughter, is your mother here?
Yeah.
Let her come. Let me recognize. You are welcome, Mama. That is good. Bless this marriage.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Blessed and mighty God, I thank you, Lord. I bless you, God. This is, oh God, in marriage, oh God, that you, God, have ordained, oh God, and you make it come to pass today, oh God. I pray, oh God, for this marriage, oh God, to be a successful marriage, oh God. Let this marriage, oh God, be a blessed marriage, oh God. Let this marriage, oh God, be a marriage, oh God, where peace and joy will come to rule and reign, oh God. You will bless them all around, oh God. You will protect them, oh God. You will guide them, oh God. Any power that wants to rise up against this marriage, oh God, your name, oh God, I come against it, oh God. I silence them up, oh God. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whether physical or spiritual, oh God, I silence on their mouth, oh God. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God, let this marriage, O God, be a marriage, O God, that your name, O God, will be glorified, O God. Thank you, Lord, I bless
thank
you for prayer and answer. For in Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Yes. What is your step, mother? Is he here? Your step, mother. Is she absent? And let her come. Yes, Mama, you are welcome. We appreciate you. Bless this marriage.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, I commit this marriage on your hand. Any evil you want to monitor after this marriage, I send the Holy Ghost fire to consume in the name of Jesus. Jehovah, my God. As you ordain them to marry, so that as you ordain them to marry, Baba, they will get children and children and children in the name of Jesus. Every hidden for this marriage, I come against her in the name of Jesus. Jehovah, my God, they shall die. This mother hand over for you. Every evil monitor, every spirit to monitor them, I send the Holy Ghost fire to consume in the name of Jesus.
Pastor, you are doing a very great work in the life of my people. Pray for them.
And so, Father, we give you glory and honor. Lord, I lift up your son and your daughter that you have joined together today into your holy hands. Lord, I wish them blessings. I wish them peace. That door that was locked against them today is declared open. I pray in the name of Jesus. The tears, the shares,
Day before yesterday, even yesterday, from this day, they will never share such tears. They walk into their joy, they walk into their fulfillment, and others will join to celebrate victory. I pray in the name of Jesus that by this time next year, we gather for dedication. In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name. Hey. Father, this hour, I present Mr. and Mrs. Francis. Teresa, before your throne of grace. Father, I thank you for your divine presence. I thank you that the power of the Most High will overshadow this family. That what we have seen today is a beginning of the glory of God upon your lives.
Amen.
That this marriage, no power can stand against it.
Amen.
No spirit can stand against
Amen.
It. We are standing in the name that is above every name. At the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, we join you together. We cover you with the blood of Jesus Christ. That your joy from today knows no bounds. Any moment you see Teresa, your heart will be flooded with joy. Any moment Teresa sees him, Francis, hey, heaven on earth, she will be glad.
Amen.
She will bless the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Father,
thank you,
that you have taken control.
Amen.
And this marriage is blessed.
Amen.
It is blessed.
Amen.
It is blessed.
Amen.
In Jesus' wonderful name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Shout louder, hallelujah. That wife you are grateful. Yes. 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 Hallelujah.
Have you seen my new mommy?
Is she the one?
Have you seen?
Are you sure? You do not tell her like she's the one. Kiss her. Congratulations. You are happy today. Hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Yes. While you married unto the registrar. Yes. In blessing from God. So you are a blessed man today. You are blessed. I say, Francis, you are blessed.
I say you are blessed in Jesus' name. So you have found a favor. Now you have found a favor. What you do with good things God has given to you. Let's turn to the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verses 9a. Let's see what the Lord has said about it. Thou lovest all the days of thy life of thy vanity, which he has given thee under the sun. Praise the Lord. Brother Francis, you are given a special command to live with this woman joyfully. Special order is given to you from above by the word of God. You should be a happy man. Be happy with her. Praise the Lord. Listen, you never know this woman. I don't know how many years you stay in your courtship, but even though you have said 10 years, you never know her. It is from today you will start to know who she is. Now, when you discover whom she is, whether beautiful or ugly, you have to love her and be happy with her. You have to take her as you see her. You have to be very, very happy. Live happily with her. Are you hearing me? That's what God has said. And this is where many men have made blunders. They are not happy with their wife because of some little errors they discover in life. Little mistakes. They build on it and become angry anytime it comes in. And there's no peace in the home. No. The Bible says, whatever situation you have found her, be happy with her. And there the blessing of God will flow in your life. Shout hallelujah. Be seated, my brother. Shout hallelujah. So the Lord give you a command. Since you have found favor with God, God has given you something precious. Be happy with what God has given to you. She's the best woman. No woman to compare her. No woman like her. There's no beautiful woman like her. In this whole hall, she's most beautiful woman. Are you hearing me? So you have to hold her tight and be happy with her. It's the best thing you have got under the sun. The best thing you have found under the sun is your wife. So be very, very happy with her every day. Are you hearing me? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And having said that, we also plead with our daughter because you do have found favor with God. Look, I see that, man. Thank you very much. You see, you have found favor with God. I've got the bone of your bone, the flesh of your flesh. You can make young girl now. When did they make you make young girl? You are St. Francis. Because you go make young girl, you know, say many men, many girls were run after Francis until they discovered you. So they jealous, So let me chip in this. Listen, Francis' phone will ring. Some people will say, "Hey, I love you." No vessel. When you see a no vessel, amen. Are you hearing me? You know, say they are women's snatchers. Are you hearing me? This man is too handsome. Oh. Not let them snatch him out of your hand. Oh. So when you see it, if you are angry, you give a room for the snatcher to come in. Are you hearing me? Take it with joy. Honey, we still calling you. I'm not beautiful enough. You will
before. I behung you. He said, don't mind them now. All those who get before. Who we are running after me. Don't mind them. And the matter will be over. Are you hearing me? It's not by fight to. The Bible says, time will come. Seven. Women will run after one man. Say, marry me. Don't worry. Marry me. I don't need your money. I can take all my children. I have my PhD. Hear me? I have a good job. I don't need your money. I don't have money. I will take off myself, take off my children. I will even take care of you. Praise the Lord. That's the time we are. Are you hearing me? Let me tell you one short story. I was in Feltac. Just one Friday, I was just sitting down in the church. A woman came in. He said, Pastor, I want to report one of your members to you. I said, my members, yes. I said, what happens? He said, you see, for 5 years, we have been moving together. And we do business together. I'm an accountant in the bank. And I will bring some contract out of the bank. I will finance it. We share the money. And moreover, I gave my message card to him. And every month, I pay him 20,000. He was paying the young man 20,000 every month. And the young man didn't know the intention of the woman. He thought, well, that business partner, I just found favor, she's just helping me. He didn't know what that sister was doing. And I said, yes, what happens now? Do you know that this man, this your member, left me to go to a small girl? I said, is this so? I was very inquisitive. I said, okay, you have his number? I said, yes. I said, give me. I called my brother. I said, where are you? He said, man, I said, come now, I want to see you now. And he came. He met the lady. I said, do you know this lady? He said, yes, it's my business partner. I said, good. I said, sister, what you have just said, repeat them again. And she repeated it. She said, yes. I said, I'm an accountant in the office. And I bring contracts out. And we share the profit. I think there's no profit. I suffer the loss. And moreover, I gave him my messages. And that's the message he came in with now. Praise the Lord. So he said, I also gave him pocket money. 20,000 every month. And now he led me to go and have a small care as a fiancé. I said, brother, is that true? He said, it is true. He said, but I have only a few questions to ask her. He said, ask her, since we are business partner, have I ever promised to marry you? He said, no, he didn't say that. He said, okay, since we were business partner, we go to hotel. Have I ever slept with you? Have I ever known your private? He said, no. He said, but I have so much on you now. Praise the Lord. So I was with the doctor and I said, man, now I know you're my true member. That you can move with a lady. Even if you go travel out, lodge in hotel, you don't sleep with her. I said, you're a man of God indeed. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. You know what? People do what you cannot do. You need to praise them. That he was able to display himself. A woman was chasing you with money, with car, with everything. You will still maintain your integrity. Brother Francis, maintain your integrity. Many of them will chase you. Maintain your integrity. You have got the best woman on earth. Are you hearing me? maintain your integrity. Many of them will chase you. Many of them will have to snatch you away from her hand. Don't give up. Tell them I am married. God bless you. You see, it is the will of God for two of you to come together. So you must maintain the will of God. But there will be peace, there will be joy in this marriage. Today, you are here to make the greatest commitment in your life. The greatest commitment. You are here to appear before this altar. That for better or worse, we will remain united. We will remain unseparated.
Amen.
When you don't do that, when you told you are going to make a vow here, when you told,
yeah.
I think you know that well.
Yes,
I'm sorry, probably we didn't give you seminar because we didn't see you. We have made it very, very clear to you. For better, for worse. Are you hearing me? Don't get home. Say, I dream and see her, she's a witch. I'm not going to marry again. No, for better, for
worse.
For better, for
worse.
So if you come to your pastor, the pastor say, endure. The pastor will say what? Endure. No matter what happens, we will say, take it easy. Wait on the Lord. Are you hearing me? Because you stand before God and man, before this holy congregation, for better, for worse. So you have entered into a serious covenant. And the Bible says that covenant cannot be broken. Time will not permit us to go into all those quotations that I have shown you. Cannot be broken. And God hates putting away. God hates divorce. Are you hearing me? God hates divorce. For that simple reason, you should get hold to your wife very tight and move together as twins and let nothing separate two of you. Are you hearing me? Your wife is beautiful. Wonderful woman. Beautiful. Hold her tight and make her more beautiful. Many people never see her beauty before. Now, from your honeymoon, people are going to see this woman. Hey, why did you not attend the queen contest? Hey, you will have won. Beautiful woman. You will have won. It is wonderful. Hey, it feels as if this country is not good for you, people. You will travel out. Amen. Hallelujah. But this weather is too harsh for her. And take her to that cool weather. Beautiful weather. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Well, that was the time, my dear. You must fulfill your responsibility. As a man, the Bible says you are the head of the house. So if anything goes wrong, God will hold you responsible. And when Adam and Eve came together, something went wrong. And Adam was trying to dodge it. He said, no, as a woman you give me. But God didn't listen. He said, though I give you a woman, you are the head of the home. You supposed to correct it. You supposed to rebuke her. You fail to do that. And that's why I have to punish you very well. So whatever goes wrong in your home, you are guilty. Praise the Lord. You know, this is where we get conflicts with the Bible. Tradition and Bible have what? Conflict. Whatever goes wrong in your home, God holds you responsible. Whether she's right or wrong, you are held responsible. But my tradition, in my tradition, hey, man is never guilty in the house. Only woman is guilty. Hello? Only woman is always guilty. Only woman apologizes to the man. Man never apologizes to woman, it's forbidden. Parley. Now, it's probably a dog. You don't see where they say, make man leave for a wife? Abomination. It never happened. At all. Man cannot kneel down for the wife. Man cannot apologize to the wife. No. It's only woman is always wrong, man is always right. Praise the Lord. And if the man beat the wife, drive the wife out, when they come to settle, that the woman will still kill goats. I mean, and the woman will still kill the fowl to bring peace into the home. And Bible doesn't support that. Bible doesn't support that. Are you hearing me? So you, the man, when you are wrong, God will tell you are wrong. Are you hearing me? You, the woman, when you are wrong, the Bible will tell you are wrong. And God can blame you for whatever you have done wrongly. So that's why I listen carefully. I want to prevent little causes of problems in marriage. Number one, inability to adjust our character. Number one thing, when they call wahala for home, when the man refuses to adjust his character as a married man, when you never marry, you can go out, you come back 12, nobody questions you. Abi? But now you are married. When you go out, you come by 9, by 8, your wife asks you, where have you? Am I making sense?
Yes, sir.
They have to question you. Why do you feel stay outside? If you do not change, she will start to suspect you. Say you are going out with another woman. Her heart begins to walk that clock. Ah, my husband, you know they come in time. I believe in the kind of woman. But how does not enter the house? So he wants you to behave in the way he likes. Are you hearing me? Not in the way you like, the way he likes. That is the way you have to behave. Rather adjust to please him. When you refuse to adjust, there will be katakata in the house. Am I making sense? Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. So, inability to adjust our character to sweep one another, we always bring wahala in the house. Number two, third party. When you allow your family to control your house. You know, so many men behave like babies. When they are married, small thing, mommy, see what my wife has done. Mom, sister, see what my wife has done. Papa, see the way my wife may behave. You are a baby. You suppose not to marry. You shouldn't sell your home. Don't allow papa, mama, sister, even friends to come into your marriage. When there's some little differences, two of you are competent to do what? And you only take out. Settle your differences. Praise the Lord. Then you will have peace. Likewise, you, my sister. The way papa marry your woman, that's not the way I'm going to marry this man. Are you hearing me? Every generation has method of living. Every generation there's a change. Are you hearing me? Probably the time your papa marry your man, they don't agree kiss. They don't agree kiss each other. But this time now, your husband is coming, you embracing, you kiss. For your own methods. Praise the Lord. So it changes. So you have to do to this man's pattern of life. But there will be peace, there will be joy, progress in the home. May God bless you in Jesus' name. Give no chance for third party. If there is at all any third party, it should be your pastor. If at all there's any third party, it should be who? Pastor. Because he will guide you with the word of God. He will not be partial. He will speak the truth that will build the home. Every good pastor is a home builder. Number three, forgiveness. You must learn to forgive this man. No sin like a sense of that time they come, they want to get you. If they make me come again. Enter house first. Because he said, not be so indeed. So this time now, you have to accept as is any way behave, forgive him. You hear me? I said to what? Forgive him. The woman that you will handle like your baby. This man, you can handle him like a baby. Put that come for your mouth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. You see, learn to forgive him. Likewise, you forgive. There will be wonderful peace in the house. Forgiveness. In a home where there's no forgiveness, there can never be peace, no progress. Things can never move well. Contracts will fail. Disappointment everywhere. Because there's no forgiveness. Learn to forgive. And God will stand by you. Whatever you put hands will prosper. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Number four. Walking without the Spirit of God. Walking without the Word of God, without Holy Bible. Are you hearing me? Walking without what? Holy Bible. You throw Bible aside. You have no time for prayers and so on. There will be trouble in the marriage. There will be trouble in the marriage. So if you want your mind to be sustained, you must learn to walk with the Word of God. You will be. So many of these people occupy posts in the church with spiritual husband or spiritual wife. Who is deceiving who? At times I go home to settle matters. What? When this woman talk, the man talk. There is nothing there. There's nothing. What they are breaking their head for is nothing. Don't you know there is something there inside? Something there inside. So demons are responsible. If your home has no peace, please meet your pastor for your deliverance. Hello? Are you hearing me? If you don't love your wife, the wife did they call honey, honey? Now when you see her, you are angry. You need what? Deliverance. You need what? Deliverance. Your husband, you were run out of honey, 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 honey. Now when you see him, you say they smell. You need what? Deliverance. When they deliver you, you don't smell again. Is somebody hearing me? Is somebody hearing me? Praise the Lord. So that is the major cause of serious problem in many homes. Demons are responsible. That is why you see some homes, so divorce, divorce, divorce. That's why you see some homes, they cannot marry. They get 35, never marry. A man, 40, 50, never marry. Do we need to see vision for you that you need deliverance? Go for the deliverance and be free. They are responsible. So when you see, why am I saying this? When you see these symptoms, you know where to go. Are you hearing me? When you see such symptoms in your marriage, you know where to go for solution. Amen. To have your solution, number one, go to the Bible. Bible standards will keep your marriage fresh. Francis, are you hearing me? If you can wake in the morning, you have morning devotion with your wife, read your Bible, your marriage will be fresh. If you can pray, your marriage will be fresh. Hallelujah. That is the solution. Number two, wisdom. The Bible says wisdom is a principal thing. Okay, turn to your Bible. First Peter. First Peter chapter 3, verse 7. Let somebody read it quickly. First Peter 3, 7. Francis, I'm reading this for you. This is for you. Yes. Yes.
Under you, therefore, which believe in.
No.
Okay, 3:7.
Yeah, thank you.
It said, likewise, your knowledge, giving honor unto the wife, as unto the weaker vessel,
and has been heard together on the great campaign, that your prayer be not
hindered. Listen, first of all, the Bible says give honor to her. Are you hearing me? They respect this woman, though. The gifts, she's your crown. Are you hearing me? Now the crown, the glory. My wife wrote a book. The glory of a man is the woman. So give her honor, give her respect. Are you hearing me? That's what you have to do to this woman. Give her that respect as your wife. She's not a slave. You know, the women came with philosophy. And they said, Pastor, you are wrong. You are wrong with your own philosophy. The philosophy is that we are not behind the man. We are beside the man. Hello, is somebody hearing me? And before we just say the woman is behind you, the woman say no, we're not there your back. We are beside you. I think that is correct philosophy. She is beside you. You know, as we want to wear it, is she behind you? She is by your side. She is by your side. So that's why you have to respect her. She's your helper. When you want to fall, she will hold you. Hey, any man, woman is supporting, not a follow. Are you hearing me? Many men have fallen because they don't believe their wife support them. I say this because I'm a pastor. I know what happens in families. Many men think they are wise, why they are fools. Please forgive me.
I know,
sir. When your wife is giving you wonderful advice that will build the family, you say, no, I know it all. No, not so. You'll be woman. After all she was saying, the time to go, you'll come back to them. Women are bundle of wisdom. Women get wisdom more. Any woman when said, when they say you won't marry, they get wisdom well. If they build the home well. Number four, love. Why you do that? Love your wife. Continuous loving. He said, love is stronger than death. So you have to love her. Don't stop loving. Just like Jesus has loved us. You see, if you settle down and read your Bible and see the love Jesus has for us, it is wonderful. It is wonderful. Apostle John said, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us to give us his son Jesus Christ, who died on the cross. And likewise you, my sister, your duty is to submit. If you don't submit, how can he love you? Is it possible to love someone who is stubborn to you? And when you are submissive, he will love you. So be submissive. Whether your submission, you accept it or not, submit. And take care. Talk to him. He will listen. Are you hearing me? Submission is needed for your marriage to succeed. Are you hearing me? God bless you. And as I said before, always forgive this man. Are you hearing me? That is the key. Forgive him. If not, his way will close. If you refuse to forgive him, you harden your heart, you cry. Hey, he's there for trouble. But when you get for trouble, it will also affect you. Do you know that? It will affect you. That is why you need to forgive him. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? No matter what he does, forgive. You know why I love women? I discovered, I say, God will answer woman prayer more than the man. Can you contest it? I say, God, they hear woman prayer better than man. Can you contest it? Praise the Lord. Yes. Let me tell you why. Listen, my brother. When you offend this woman, the thing pain her heart. When she come here,
to pray, tears will just come down. When God see the tears, what it go happen? He go answer her quickly. Before man pray, tears will come down. Brother, how many times you don't pray, tears come down? I'm telling every woman here, when you need that to pray, you go see tears. God will say, my daughter, I don't hear you. Stand up, please. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for today. You are worthy of all our praise. Father, for this message, heal all the broken bones. Heal all the broken bones. From today, I commit all broken bones into your hand. Help us to rebuild the homes and let their marriage be sweet like honey. In the name of Jesus. Today, your son, Francis and Teresa, we are laying foundation for their marriage. Give them the understanding. Amen. Give them wisdom. Amen. Because wisdom is, will follow you.
Amen.
You will bump boy.
Amen.
You will bump girls.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, my Lord, that this marriage is blessed.
Amen.
And the glory of God will cover them.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you.
the plate. And delicious. The best traditional is the let the husband locate them today.
Amen.
They will not live here without seeing their husband.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Many brothers who are looking for wife, may you locate your wife today.
Amen.
May you see your wife. Oh.
Amen.
May your eye be open to see your wife. Oh.
Amen.
You have done it. And as many as come to this wedding from far and near, we cover you with the blood of Jesus. Go in peace. To God's glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Share the grace with me. The grace of God, Jesus Christ, the Lord of God, and sweet fellowship, the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy will follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Do we take the program here or outside?
Outside.
Okay, move this.
God bless you.
Your charms,
my love,
oh Lord,
king of faculty and science. Which of the institution? Unibet. Okay. Then we have also in our midst Mrs. Ekwebase. Okay, DJ, thank you. Right about now, we are going to bring the latest couple in town. They are the music while we are here. So please, we do them a lot of good. We honor them.
Can't you see me? Can you jam your hands together for them? We don't have time. I'll quickly run down this list. If you are inside the hall, you just majestically take a walk to the high table. It says the opening prayers. Hallelujah. Do we have, okay?
Bless your wonderful day. We thank you, Lord, for this gathering at this hour. We thank you, Lord, for your love, for your mercies. This is the second standard of this occasion. We commit this gathering into your holy hands, Lord. Father, we pray, let your will be done, O Lord. Father, King of glory, all that we are going to do here, Lord, my heavenly Father, I pray, let your perfect will be done, O Lord. Lord, we pray in the name of Jesus. Father, we commit this marriage into your holy hands, Lord. Today is the day that you have ordained in heaven, that this marriage, this couple, should come together as husband and wife. And they have done this. I pray, Lord, my heavenly Father, you are the great provider. Come and provide for them, O Lord. Materially, provide for them. Children, wife, provide them, O Lord. Financially, Lord, my heavenly Father, provide for them, O Lord. We that have come, O Lord, my heavenly Father, to grace this occasion, I pray, Lord, my heavenly Father, also bless us, O Lord. As many that have come from far and near, Lord, my heavenly Father, I pray, grant us journey mercy, O Lord. So, at the end, O Lord, your name be glorified. Thank you, Father, for answering prayer. Jesus, wonderful day we pray.
Amen.
If you are living so sharp, hallelujah.
Okay, please, Pastor Mrs. Egaga, you're welcome to the high table. Pastor Mrs. Egaga.
Amen.
Please follow me carefully. I want to take you somewhere. DJ. I was reading a book some time ago and I came across a session that says, though you are not born with a silver spoon, but if you make efforts through life, you will produce one for yourself. Is that true, my people?
Mama.
And then it says, though you are not born with a silver spoon, but if you make efforts through life, you will produce one for yourself. Is that true, my people? You are not responding. Let me interpret that. Don't say they're not calling you as a brother. But if you struggle through life, at the end of the day, you want to be millionaire. Because when you go born as a brother, it will be true of us.
True.
I want to answer that. True of us.
It's true.
But show them as a brother. That's true. I want to answer that. Let me make money for me. What is it called? As a brother. But this one, as a brother.
Afternoon. We also welcome you on behalf of the Faculty of Life Science, the Dean is here. And Dr. Elisa is a staff of that faculty. We welcome you on behalf of the Christ Chosen Church of God and all the faithful. We welcome all of you and our friends and well wishers for being here this afternoon. We thank you. There is a lot to drink, to eat and drink, and so we ask you to bear with us and fellowship with them, and in particular pray for them, for the success of their home. We pray that the Holy Spirit, their home will be overfull and overfilled with the Holy Spirit. That it will be the presence of Christ will always be with them. The angels will watch over them. And we invite you to join me in this prayer song. It shall be permanent. It shall be permanent. What you all have done for us. It shall be permanent.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. the Lord. Thank you, thank you.
Please clap your hands together for our chairman. Cake designer, please get ready. For popular demand sake, I want to drop this. I discovered women are the most important people in the universe. True or false? All the doctors who this life are women born there. True or false? What an answer now. Now women born all the governors and the president. True or false? Now women have born everybody who there here. True or false? Who born Boko Haram? Who born all the thief? The Bible says, train up a child in the way he or she should go, and when they grow, they will not depart from it. So now you take train your pikin. Now I go determine what he will be for life. I don't talk about Ishan woman, I go marry. Ishan woman. You know why? If you marry a Benin woman, problem boss for house. Not be me when they listen to now. What's in the picture? Now they watch. Now they watch love, I mean. Now love, now they watch. Okay. If you marry a Benin woman, problem boss for house. Now street, now they settle the matter. Why I talk like that? One man slapped his wife from the house. That was last 2 weeks. The woman boss cried, Iyeme! Asabiyama! Walado! Amesa! But if na Isha woman, if you give Isha woman slap, instead of her to the shark, the cross street, he gonna sing for you. As you slap her like this, bah! He gonna remember the time when Papa told her, say, may not marry you. He gonna begin to sing. Is it a Lego bueno? Is it a Lego bueno? I let me speak fornication. True of us. As a lady, if you engage in perpetual privacy with a guy, you will come out with pregnancy. I talk like. Okay? There's a big difference between the white man preacher and a black man preacher. Now this is not a look at them. They have our first and first. They don't pause and thank you. After this one, I will invite the cake designer. If you see the white man preaching, praise the Lord.
John 3, verse 16.
Please just take the whole verse and I keep on preaching. Thank you.
John 3, sustain for God to love the world. He is only begotten Son, whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Thank you. You see, God so loved the world, and he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever that believeth in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. You will see preaching is sweet. You're going to hear preaching. Preaching is sweet. But if you travel from Obodo, you won't go to Nigeria. You don't see the way our preacher today preach. Together for Pastor Chidebere to come and give us the word for today. Pastor Chidebere will come up like this. Praise the Lord, somebody. Want to respond now?
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah.
Today, I will take my double lesson from the book of John 3, verse 16. Brother Collins!
Come
for me.
Yes, sir.
John 3:16.
John
3:16.
For counsel of the word, oh.
For God.
And he gave his only begotten Son.
Please clap your hands together for Nigeria preachers. Hallelujah. Right about now, I will invite our cake designer. She is no other person than the person of faith. Eva Duwoden. I will mention her. Eva Duwoden. Abby, I'll not get her. Tell me for you. Eva Duwoden. Eva Duwoden. Please jam your hands together for her. At least today, I don't know how to pronounce your name.
Papa, catch you in trouble.
Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want to bore you with too much speeches and too many grammar. I'm here representing my oga at the top, and we have our cake, our beautiful cake here, handmade and very simple, lovely, looking good with just simple combinations like that. Yes. We all know that to prepare cake and to make cake, you need different ingredients. That's the same thing as that applied to marriage. If you want to go into marriage, you should know that there are so many things you can encounter in your marriage. Marriage is not so sweet, so don't expect that this cake will cause the difference for you. Thank you very much. So let me just go to the colors. We have red, we have watermelon, and we have white. Okay. Love. We are praying that as Bro Frank and Sister Tessie have come together in one unity, that they will continually expressing love and experiencing love all the whole days of their life. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Wait till I have a look now. Now let me shout. Amen.
Amen.
If you shout amen, you go live long. The buttermilk here, which represents peace, which represents, it's a cool color, so it represents harmony. So we pray that our sister Teresa and your friend have come together in unity. They will continue to express and to experience peace and harmony in their family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now let's shout again.
Amen.
Thank you. At this junction, I want to call on the bride and groom for their normal, for their first phase of, what is it called, responsibility for English. Anyway, come on, you concern me like that. Thank you. Sister Tete, Brother Fafra, DJ, please, music. Music. They all come up now, and thank you. Music, your call now, thank you. Music, no, no, never have, your dance. Hey, father.
There's something I want you to do. You know, we've been watching them, we've been kissing and doing something like that.
Abby?
She was not a mother. She was not a gift to her husband.
Together for them as they come forth. This is a moment they are going to remember all the days of their lives. Please please come to this platform so that the people this on this angle and this side can see you very well. Come this way. Just come this way. Thank you very much. Just face your husband, face your wife. Okay? Okay, sir, can you stand this way? Stand here. Thank you. Face your wife. Right about now, this is a movement.
Jeff?
DJ, thank you, thank you. This is a movement they are going to remember even when problems seem to be arising at home. When they remember this moment, they will move on with their normal life in Jesus' name. Now, sir, please, can you draw close to your wife? Just begin to give her those promises you used to give her in the love garden. Just begin to tell her what the future owes the both of you. You will take care, you will work hard to ensure the children does not go outside to beg. You will ensure that she is comfortable, you will not beat her. Just begin to give her those love promises, the future owes the both of you. Just begin to tell her. When you begin to tell him that which you owe him, your respect, your love, forever. 5 minutes, one, two, go. Oh, blood of God. Blood of Jesus. 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 4 minutes. You never do that. Oh, Jesus. I feel like getting married right now. Oh, blood of God. 5 minutes, please jump your hands together for them. Wherever you are, just stretch your hands to them. Wherever you are, just stretch your hands to them. We are going to pray for them. I will do the prayers and you will say amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. By this time next year, you will be reaping the fruit of this wedding in Jesus' name. Amen. You will not regret treading this path in Jesus' name. Amen. You will live long to see your children's children in the name of Jesus. Amen. I say you will live long to see your children's children in the name of Jesus. Amen. You will grow old till you get to 130 years in Jesus' name. Yeah. You gonna live long, so your teeth gonna break finish in Jesus' name. You're not gonna chop meat again and so out in Jesus' name. Thank you, join your hands together for them. They are going to have their first blood chat dance right away. Nobody is coming here, they are going to dance alone. Please, kitchen. Ketra, please just make sure the hall is busy. They are going to have their first doctor dance right away. Nobody should come here. That was a wonderful moment. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, right about now, we are going to call the best man to come and do the toast. Best man, please, wherever you are, come and see. Say, talk to the hands. Powerful now. Are you suspecting now? The other day, we did bank, inside bank. I meet very long queue. One woman where cashier is supposed to attend to. She can't come up for queue, go receive call. As she come back, another person, cashier go there attend to her. That woman said, no, excuse me, this is my position. That cashier asked the woman, where were you? Come on, where were you? Come on, where were you? The woman cannot talk. Where were me? Where me? Where me not here just now? Me, I come up for here to receive phone call. I come back, you are asking me where me? That woman, what I come here today. Brother, we are not here. say, you get here, oh. You get here. Now somebody look at your neighbor, say neighbor. Say neighbor. Say neighbor. Say neighbor. Say neighbor. Now look at the person very well. The person is looking very beautiful and gorgeous. Say neighbor. Say neighbor. You are wonderful, looking wonderfully made. Now look at the person very well again. If the person is ugly, frown your face. Frown your face. Look at the person. Say no. You have not seen any shaman when they pray before. You have not seen any shaman they pray. If this shaman they pray, they hear something like this. Abamen, abamen. You keep that up here. God help you. Believe me, there you are. Idiot, the oh yeah. When I talk now, idiot, the oh yeah. Now, therefore, believe was in 97 years old to my bleach. That's why I'm a couple of my year one day. In your woman, bleach, in yourself, and I say, I need your car. We need women that are okay. So if you go travel on the bus, we'll tell you so sad, mama. I want to ask the women to discover about Bini women. They like swag a lot. All the Bini women, please jump your hands together for yourself. They like swag a lot. I see one Bini woman for Ring Road the other day. She carries stick, she never can't go like this. Our partner, yeah, yeah. Now I can't go with that. Iye, a rapper went the other day. Iye told me, I said, I swagger me no. For English word, they call out the waist. Now therefore, we didn't see. Now Iye, now Iye, now Iye. She don't use Blackberry. I don't feel as though visit her the last time. As I recommend, so we made the opinion, women. We did women. Hey. God help us in Jesus' name. Now, best way we want our toast. Are you ready? Okay, please jump ahead.
For me, my Savior went for me.
gentlemen. Please keep your rooms and help with your kids' items. Please don't go from there. There's a gift for them here.
Yeah. to our chairman as he closed out with a word of prayer. DJ, please, can you kill the music? DJ, kill the music, thank you.
Hello. Hello. Praise the Lord. God bless the man and woman. My wife will do the closing prayer.
In Jesus' name,
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus, Father and God, we thank you, Lord, for this union of today between Tessie and Frank, as Mr. and Mrs. Omori. Father and God, we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity. We thank you, Lord, for everything you have done for their lives. Father and God, we thank you for making it possible for those of us who came for this ceremony to be here. Lord and God, we beg you, Lord, to bless this marriage with all the good things of life in Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord, for your patience. We thank you, Lord, for being able to accommodate us in this call, this evening. Lord and God, as we depart from here, Lord, may we not depart from your presence in Jesus' name. All those people who have traveled from far and near for this ceremony, as we depart, Lord, Father, Lord, give each and every one of us joy and mercy to our respective destinations in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, my God, may Mr. and Mrs. Omori continue to express your presence in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your presence continuously take preeminence in their lives in Jesus' name. These and many other blessings we ask you, Lord, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Your maga, I want to be your maga, your lover. Baby, please give it. Oh. I'm going crazy. Oh, let me be your maga, your maga. I want to be your maga, your lover. Tell me what you want. Oh oh oh, hey. I just wanna know your need. Cause the way you touch the body, I like the way you do the body, body. Make me want to the gummy body, the gummy body.
Ha, okay.
Oh yeah, the popo. Baby, let me go the popo.
Ah.
Oh yeah, the popo. Baby, let me go the popo. Cause you go the popo. So let me go the popo. Oh yeah. Tonight. Oh tonight. Baby, please give me. I'm going crazy. Your maga, I want to be your maga, your lover. Baby, please give me. I'm going crazy. Oh, let me be your maga, your maga. I want to be your maga, your lover. There's something about this your body where they make me the jolly. When I see you, my baby, I just like you happy. Oh, 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 my baby. Do they sweep it up, oh, oh, my baby. Tonight, oh yeah, the popo.
Baby, let me go the popo.
What?
Oh yeah, the popo.
Ah.
Baby, let me go the popo.
Okay.
Cause you go the popo.